Yes, good morning. Namaste. Today I want to discuss Pallavas. Here in this video, I discuss Pallava rulers. There are 12 prominent Pallava rulers. Total many Pallava rulers are there. These 12 are prominent rulers in Pallava dynasty. Yes, here actually. There is no clarity on the name of founder of Pallava dynasty, but the rise of Pallavas in the last quarter of the 6th century is attributed to Simha Vishnu. Yes, Mahendravarma I is the considered to be the greatest ruler of Pallavas. His reign was marked by many architectural and literary achievements which would lay the foundation of the future art and culture of South India. Kanchipuram was the capital of Pallavas, and Shore temple at Mahabalipuram, and the Kanchi Kailasanatha temple at Kanchipuram are famous temples that were constructed during the reign of Pallavas. Now we know political history of Pallavas. Actually, the origin of Pallavas is a mystery. There are several theories propounded by historians. Some historians say that they are branch of Pethian people, that is actually tribe of Iran, who gradually migrated to South India. That is one theory about Pallava's origin. Some says they are an indigenous dynasty that rose within the southern region and were a mix of various tribes. That is another theory. And next to some experts believe that these Pallavas to be of Naga origin, who first settled the Tondaimandalam region near, that is Tondaimandalam region is Madras, near Madras. Madras means Chennai. Another theory says that they are descended from a Chola prince and a Naga princess of Manipallavam. Actually Manipallavam is an island of Jaffna and Sri Lanka. Yes, some other of the opinions that are the Pallavas are feudatories of Satavahanas. And the first Pallava kings ruled during the 4th century AD. There were three kingdoms in South India waning for supremacy. They are Chalukyas of Badami, next to Pandyas of Madurai, and Pallavas of Kanchipuram. Next to another school, opinion of that Pallavas were a branch of the Brahmin royal dynasty of Vakatakas of the Dakkan. Yes, another ingenious dynasty that rose to power after dismemberment of the Ikshvakula kingdom. Yes, the extent of the Pallava dynasty, the Pallava's capital was Kanchipuram. Next, their territories at the height of their powers extended from the northern part of Andhra Pradesh to river Kaveri in the south. During the 7th, the Cholas were reduced to a marginal state by the authority of the Pallavas. Watapi, that is Badami, was the occupied by the Pallava king Narasimha Varma, who defeated the Chalukyas. The Kalabras ruled Tamil region 3rd century to 6th century after the early Cholas, early Pandyas and Cheras. These this Kalabras uprising was crushed by the Pandyas, Chalukyas and Pallavas jointly. The Kalabras were protesting against the numerous land granted by the Brahmadeya to Brahmins made by the Brahminic rulers of the their dynasty. After the decline of Sangam age in the Tamil country, yes, I think you know what is Sangam age. Sangam, that is actually Sangam means that is association. Yes, that is sabha like. That is literature. Tamil literature flourished during that period. This Kadamba rulers lost it for about 250 years. Rulers of the Pallava Empire are 12 prominent rulers are there. First we discuss in this video 12 rulers. In the second video I will discuss administration, architecture, art and architecture, literature and next society, social conditions and judiciary system, everything that is administrative divisions, everything we discuss in the next video. Now we discuss rulers of Pallava Empire. First, Sivaskanda Varma. This 4th century, actually Sivaskanda Varma, greatest among the early rulers, ruled at the beginning of the 4th century performed Ashwamedha and other Vedic sacrifices. But historians not accepted Sivaskanda Varma is the founder of Pallavas. Simha Vishnu Varma is the founder of Pallavas. Yes, next to come to this Simha Vishnu Varma. This Simha Vishnu Varma, also known as Simha Varma, he is the founder of Pallavas. He is considered the first important Pallava ruler. Through Pallavas extended even during the time of Samudragupta's invasions of South India. He is credited with capturing the territories of the Cholas and humiliating his other south neighbors including Ceylon. He followed Vaishnavism as is evident from archaeological evidence. This Simha Vishnu Varma was the first Pallava monarch who extended his authority beyond Kanchipuram, that is Kanchi. Kanchipuram in his son. This a drama written by his son Mahendra Varma, in which he was patriot as the great conqueror in Mattavilasa Prahasanam. The meaning of Mattavilasa Prahasanam is drunken revelry. Including he invaded including Sri Lanka in his completed he occupied Sri Lanka also. Next to third ruler, prominent ruler, Mahendra Varma I. Mahendra Varma I is he himself a poet and composer. He composed Vichitra Chitta and Mahavilasa Prahasaram or Mattavilasa Prahasaram. Next to another, this book is not available, but Bhagavata Jukha is another book also he has written, but the script is not available now. Next, he introduced rock cult temple in architecture. Next, his temples architecture built five-celled cave temples at Pallavaram. Next, Kokeswara temple. Next, Trikuteswaram of Pudukkottai is in Tamil Nadu. Yes, initially Mahendra Varma follow Jainism, later he follow he converted to Saivate. Next he follow Saivism on going rivalry with Pulakesi II of Chalukya dynasty. He died in the battle with Pulakesi II. Pulakesi II. Next to Narasimhavarma I. Narasimhavarma I is the greatest of the Pallavas. Also called Narasimha Varma Mahamallala or Mallala. Mamala. He defeated and killed Pulakesi II in 1642 CE. Took control of Vatapi, the Chalukya capital, and assumed the title Vatapi Konda. Also, vanquished the Cholas, Cheras, and Panjas, sent to a naval expedition to the Sri Lanka, and reinstated the Sinhalese prince Manivarma. He founded the city of Mamallapuram or Mahabalipuram, and Huyang Sang visited to Kanchi in 440 that is CE, and he described the people living in his country as happy, and there was an abundance of agriculture product. Great Nayanar saints like Appar, Ganesambadar, and Siruttodar lived during his reign. Next to Mahendravarma II. Yes, this Mahendravarma II, yes, actually this is important for objective. That's why I mentioned Mahendravarma II. Mahendravarma II killed by Chanakya king Vikramaditya I. This Vikramaditya I is the son of Pulakesi II. Yes, next is Parameswara Varma I. Yes, he had to face the invasion forces of the Vikramaditya I, but finally succeeded in defeating. Next to Narasimhavarma II. Yes, complete Narasimhavarma. He ruled in a marked by the peace and prosperity. Literature activities and the constructions of large and beautiful temples like the Shore Temple at Mamallapuram and Kailasanatha Temple at Kanchi. Next to Iswara and Mukunda temples, the Panamalai temple in South Arcot, and Vaikuntha Perumal temple in Tamil Nadu. Yeah, all these temples he constructed. Narasimhavarma II constructed. He sent ambassadors to China, and maritime trade flourished in his period. Next to Parameswara Varma II. This the Chalukyas Vikramaditya II attacked the Pallava capital, and Parameswara Varma had to conclude a humiliating treaty with him. He was killed by the Ganga ally of the Chalukyas. He was the last ruler of Simha Vishnu lane of Pallavas. After this, Simha Vishnu's younger brother. Lineage started. This Nandivarman II is the lineage of Simha Vishnu Varma's brothers lineage. Yes, Nandivarma II, he built the Vaikuntha Perumal temple, and intellectual with aptitude in many arts like writing poetry, next to music and philosophy. He is credited with augmenting temple dramatized dance worship like Kutiyattam, that is dance style, and Chakyar Kuttu, these two are dance styles with many players of the his own, like Kuchipudi. In Kuchipudi, that is actually I think you watch many times in on Doordarshan, and especially Doordarshan only telecast this. That is what is Parvati Kalyanam, like that is many people, Srinivasa Kalyanam, many dancers participate, many dancers appear on the stage. These two dance practices, Kutiyattam and Chakiyar Kuttu, these two practices are group dancing. Yes, yes, here defeated the Chalukya allies, the Gangas, the Pandyas, and the worship of Vishnu, and a great pattern of learning. Several old temples were renovated by Nandivarma too. Next, Dantivarma. He Dantivarma ruled 51 years, but he ruled, he balanced, he kept the Chalukyas, Pallavas dynasty without invasions and without loss. He maintained, he stabilized the Pallavas. There is no controversies, no credits, nothing in during Dantivarma's period. Next to Nandivarma II. Yes, Nandivarma II is a powerful monarch. He tried to reverse the decline that began the reign of his father. Actually, just he maintained. Whenever the other rulers of Kadambas, whatever the areas they lose, Gangas, whatever the areas they lose, and next to Cheras, Pandyas, slowly Vishnukundanis, all some this some part of little part of Chalukyas, these Pallava rulers occupied. But before Dantivarma just maintained. What they watch everything, the developments of the this neighbor dynasty, all the other kings who watch this this Dantivarma just maintained peace and prosperity in the country. He is not preferred too much wars. He never declared the wars, and whomever declared the war, yes, just he protest is himself. And he come, he save his dynasty, his country. Yes, actually his provision, prominence, his prominence. But actually, that is that other kings of Vishnukundalis are eastern Gangas and Kadambas, Chalukyas, Pandyas, and Cheras. These kings felt that this Pallavas lost their power. So after Dantivarma, Nandivarma III, again he began to reign of the his father declined, started decline, but he bring again he bring this Pallava dynasty into the limelight. A powerful navy and maintained trade contracts with Saima and Malaya. Next and last Pallava ruler is Aparajita Varma. He is the last ruler of Pallavas. He was killed by Adichavan is Cholas ruler in 897. Actually, the Pallava chiefs continued to extend till the end of this 13th century. These Pallava rulers, after Aparajita Varma, all the Pandyas and this Kadambas, Vishnukundalis, they occupy the Pallavas. But these Pallavas are continued till 13th century as the feudatories. Yes, In the next video, I will discuss administration of Pallavas, that is administrative system of Pallavas, judiciary system of Pallavas, and army revenue system of Pallavas, education and literature of Pallavas, next to society of Pallavas, religion of Pallavas, Pallavas art and architecture. Next to art and architecture is very vast topic, very important also. Fine arts, this spread of Indian culture, everything we discuss, because actually this Pallavas art and architecture is very, very important. Yes, many times this on basis of art and architecture we get the questions in our exams. So we have to know this art and architecture thoroughly. Yes, thank you for watching my video. Yes, please subscribe and watch more videos. Thank you. Jai Hind. Have a nice day. All the best for the aspirants. Thank you.